everybody. This is Aaron Hollard. And
Pollard.
Okay. And just tell us a bit of your background.
What kind of background? Like, why I'm here, or?
Yeah, why you're here.
I'm in the criminal justice program. I'm a student representative with the LCSA now. I come from Edmonton, Alberta. I moved down here for school.
How was Edmonton?
Edmonton's, it's good. It's big. It's different. Yeah. There's not nearly as much wind in Edmonton.
Oh, it's definitely not.
It's a bigger city. Like, I didn't learn how to drive because there was always ways for me to get around until I had to come down here.
Okay.
So, like, I could always take a bus or ride my bike. I need to get anywhere, or I have my mom and dad.
Definitely. You get around then. So what brought you to Lethbridge?
I started looking at the criminal justice programs that were offered throughout the country and throughout the province. And Lethbridge College had one of the best recognized from everybody that I've heard, all the research that I've done. The only other college that I heard about that had a halfway decent criminal justice program was Bow Valley. And I was accepted to Bow Valley, but I chose to come here instead.
So you chose Lethbridge. Mm-hmm. What was the downfall of Bow Valley?
Was it Calgary?
Yeah.
No, it was just, I didn't hear as much good from Bow Valley as I did hear from Lethbridge, so.
Okay.
Plus, Lethbridge was further away from home, so it was a bit of a different experience.
Cool. So, do you have any hobbies you like to do?
I like to paint.
Paint? What specific do you like to paint?
I like to paint on objects. Like, right now, for every Christmas for the past 3 years now, I paint ornaments.
So you're very Christmassy.
I'm very Christmassy. I'm so excited for Christmas right now.
Nice. Other than painting, is there anything else?
I like to sing. I love music. I'm trying to get into golf. It's not working. My boyfriend, he plays golf, and he's now down in Pennsylvania.
Oh, so he's trying to get you on golf then.
Yeah. I met him here last year, and then he went to Pennsylvania.
So back on the golfing. How bad actually?
Oh, it's awful. I have I went to one driving range since then, and it's just all skitter across the ground.
Don't
work on that, but can't expect much from a person who's the first time to pick up a club.
Okay. So a different topic. How many siblings or what is your family like?
I have one older brother who's in Cochrane right now. He's an engineer.
Okay.
I have a mom and a dad. Mom's manages a store up in Edmonton, and my dad works for the city of Edmonton bylaw, community standards with commercial vehicle enforcement.
Okay.
And I have a dog who I miss.
Yeah.
He's I can see her Christmas, so I'm excited for that.
Nice.
I was talking to my mom about her, and she's apparently she'd be very much a diva.
So, your dad was heavily into Justice Criminal Act too. So, is that how you kind of got influenced by it?
I first was going to go into criminology. I was going to become a criminologist, but then I looked at what I was expecting from my future career choice with that. And with that, I decided it would be far too depressing.
Yeah.
I didn't want to constantly surround myself with all this crime and murder and all this bad going on. I wanted something to look forward to. So that's why I kind of chose to go towards policing instead.
Okay.
Because I still be able to help people. And less trying to catch the killer or catch the bad guy, more help the good people that need help.
Definitely, okay. So are you a big person that likes to say help people a lot? Like, are you that kind of caring person that just goes out of the way?
Oh yeah, absolutely. It gets me in trouble sometimes. I'm that person that my friends constantly come to if they have issues. Like, I'm the one that's always there. I try to keep a level head. Sometimes it piles up and I need to go and seclude myself a little bit, but when that happens, they're usually pretty understanding.
Nice. How are we doing for time, Chris?
One more minute.
All right. So this random question. What's
The craziest thing that ever happened to me. I almost got disowned by my mom.
Holy, really?
Yeah. I got a tattoo last year, and
okay.
Like she went crazy about it, and thankfully we worked it out and she's been understanding, but in the heat of the moment where it's like, how dare you do that? Thankfully my dad was a bit more understanding.
Yeah.
It was weird when I told my dad, I was like, Dad, what do you think would happen if I got a tattoo? And he's like, well, I have to go get one. I was like, well, I better go get one then.
Yeah.
He's like, are you serious? I'm like, yeah.
Well,
yeah.
Nice. Thank you for coming
on. Yeah, no, thank you.
It was a pleasure.